Imagine a cave with a prisoner chained facing the back wall. Let's call him Truman. Truman can't move or even turn his head. All he sees is the wall, that singular reality that's presented to him. Behind him is a fire in front of which animals and people pass by, allowing Truman to see their shadows on the wall. But one day, Truman breaks free and turns around to see that the shadows were just that. Shadows, figures, images, mere variations of a new reality he'd just recently discovered. He eventually learns that fire burns, that the sun shines, that he was blinded by the darkness of his cave. This leads Truman to question his assumptions, to look beyond the cave, to reason. Devoid of ignorance, Truman is no longer a prisoner. He is a philosopher, a lover of wisdom, a true man exposed to reality. The way most people interpret Plato's allegory of the cave is by taking note of the lesson that we shouldn't be ignorant, that we should constantly strive to seek knowledge and gain perspective in order to approach truth and meaning. And as much as I agree with that, I feel like we often neglect to appreciate the assumption behind this allegory, an assumption which I think holds true. The idea that our opinions and perceptions are shaped by all which surrounds us, thereby making us products of our own environment.
Look what I got free at the checkout. It's a chef's pal. It's a dicer, grater, peeler all in one. Never need sharpening, dishwasher safe.
Despite all the powerful themes of surveillance, consumerism, reality TV, free will, etc. that the film evokes, I think it's worth dissecting what makes the Truman Show possible. Because the idea of Truman goes beyond his show or his character, or even the actor playing that character. The idea of Truman extends to all of us. You're watching Screenview Mirror. I'm your host, Emma, and this is my take on the Truman Show.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.
The Truman Show is based upon the same assumption as Plato's allegory. We are ultimately products of our own environment. How we think and what we do is based on the information that we have access to. For instance, Truman is afraid of the water because he saw his father drown in a storm. He drinks the same brand of beer every time he meets his friend because that's what his best friend does. He wants to fly to Fiji because that's where the love of his life is supposed to have moved to. The places, people, and things around us influence how we think and how we act, thereby helping us become aware of who we are. But the show and/or film take this concept even further, because Truman is not only a product of his environment, but his environment is literally a production set for him. In 1967, sociologist Irving Goffman conducted a microfunctionalist study of symbolic interactionism, noting that people engage in what he called face and line, which in turn form the habitus of each individual. He emphasized that we have a system of dispositions or ways of thinking that are socially determined and which are reflected in our actions and belief systems. In other words, the various social environments we inhabit explain why we code switch and make the distinctions between different social bubbles, why we're not the same person in the classroom or at a party or with our families. And this is why it's so important to recognize that our perceptions, our opinions, our thoughts, our actions, that the whole nine yards of life and selfhood are fundamentally restricted to one environment or another, which is not necessarily a bad thing if we are aware of this. As long as we understand that every person comes with their own bubble and that each environment is different, that's completely fine. Yet the fake vanilla production design of the show and the caricature acting remind us that the show is not real, and that Truman's selfhood has been sterilized and reproduced for manufactured entertainment.
What's he doing?
See, they got rid of her, but they couldn't erase the memory.
The memory of who?
That's precisely what makes The Truman Show so unsettling to watch. The viewers of both The Truman Show, the film, and The Truman Show, the show, are aware that Truman doesn't know he is a prisoner within a cave, unable to move or act freely, subject to other people's perceptions, his character stripped of a kind of personality fingerprint. It's only when Truman breaks away from that cave that he's able to begin living in greater awareness of his environment. Overall, I can see how the message of this video is a bit obvious and unremarkable, but more often than not, it's the obvious and unremarkable that are often overlooked and taken for granted. Ultimately, we do live in different bubbles and perform on different social stages, which partially explains why perception is a fingerprint, unique to each individual, but also a mere drop in the ocean of society.
In case I don't see ya. Good afternoon, good evening, and good night.
All right, so I hope you enjoyed this week's video. Keep watching movies, keep reflecting on cinema, and reflecting cinema to others. Stay tuned. I'll see you next week. This was Screenview Mirror.
We've become bored with watching actors give us phony emotions. We're tired of pyrotechnics and special effects. While the world he inhabits is in some respects counterfeit, there's nothing fake about Truman himself. No scripts, no cue cards. It isn't always Shakespeare, but it's genuine. It's a life.